Coming up, we have the first of our exhibition matches. It looks like Eric Truzel on Frontier versus Pathfinder. Both wrestlers are fighting for inside control. Feeling each other out at the beginning of the match. Oh, Eric Truzel gets a shot off, single leg. But it looks like the Pathfinder wrestler successfully sprawled. No takedown points awarded so far. Oh, there's Eric Truzel, he got us two. And on top, he breaks him down with a cross wrist ride. And he starts to spin him. It looks like he's going to attempt to throw half Nelson on him. He's going to throw the half and drive his hips. Try to roll him. You know, Coach Gordon always says, once you're on your stomach, soon you're going to be on your back. Don't worry. Give it time. So he still has the cross wrist ride. He's keeping the control in the match. There's 35 seconds to go. So Eric has the ankle pick and the cross wrist ride, and he breaks him down. Now he's flat on his stomach, 20 seconds to go. Both wrestlers fighting as the match comes to a close. The period, rather. And it looks like he's flipped. Oh, and he rolls through. He ends up on his stomach. And he survives the period. Green wins the coin toss. So it's Pathfinder's choice. He chooses top, so Eric Truzel will be on the bottom for Frontier. These exhibition matches are a good opportunity for JV wrestlers to get experience before they're thrown into varsity. And the start of the match, the period is underway. And Eric Truswell, he's going for his escape. But it looks like there's a cradle coming from Pathfinder. Anytime your knee almost touches your head like that, it's never a good thing.
Yeah, that's not a good position to be in at all.
And he's trying to throw the half Nelson to crank him over. But Eric Truswell, he has the leg. He's not going to let him do so.
One 16 to go in the second period.
So the Pathfinder wrestler is trying to link his hands together, and Truswell just broke his grip and he got the reversal.
That's good for 2 points.
Yep. Green gets the escape. Truswell goes in for the shot, but Pathfinder sprawls. But the sprawl looks like it'll be unsuccessful.
Looks like he's got the position. Although he spins back. Oh, he's got Truswell's him down.
Truswell gets the two, and he's going to try to crank him over for the pin. Looking over to his coaches for help. And there he has him.
Looks like he's got him hooked.
12 seconds to go. Pathfinder could fight his way through this, but Truswell has him in a pretty good position for now.
Oh, and he's able to survive.
And that'll be a 3-point near fall.
It's the score on the, so it's 7-1 in favor of Frontier on the scoreboard for the third period upcoming. How long do you have to have in that position to be qualified for a near fall?
A near fall will be more than 5 seconds. So when the referee is counting, he can assign back points if you're on your back for anywhere between 1 and 3 seconds, 1 and 5 seconds, up to 3 points. He's got the leg. Truzo gets the reversal.
So he's cracking up the points now with 2 minutes to go in this third period.
Truzo's trying to crank him over in the Pathfinder wrestler's trying to break his grip and get the escape point.
These are younger wrestlers, so they'll be doing this for a few years to come. Too early to develop rivalries among other wrestlers in your area? I mean, do wrestlers have rivalries all the way through high school?
Yes, they definitely do have rivalries.
Truzo trying to spin back and avoid the pullover. 1 minute to go.
Oftentimes the 1 and 2 seeds for each weight division, they'll be wrestling each other all year, see who can beat who and get the higher seed for Western Mass.
I bet those Western Mass tournaments are a scene. He's really got Truesball's arm hyperextended there. Oh, that looked painful.
Truesball is out of trouble, but he gets the reversal points.
It makes it 11-5 with 30 seconds left. Seconds to go.
And Truesdale looks like he's going to maintain possession or control. Oh, this could be a reversal here. That's a reversal.
And time is out.
Close match, 9-7.
Very close. Very entertaining, too. No, actually, they looked like he got that last 2 points. They gave it to Truesdale, so. It's tied on the scoreboard, but he wins. Now who's next? So we got a few more matches, it looks like.
Yeah, right now, Tanner Finch is getting ready for a match. This will be his second match of the day.
Is it uncommon to wrestle more than one match in a day?
No. When you're at a tournament, you can wrestle up to 5 matches just on that one day.
This is Alex Scrocky.
Oh, Tanner gets the headlock, cranks it over.
He has a scissors.
She's trying to force them out of bounds.
All their legs are still in bounds, though.
Yep.
Minute 13 to go. He's really got her cinched in.
Just under a minute left in the period. This is a long time to fight a headlock.
Yeah.
Down there on the bottom.
Well, she's fighting it for sure. She's trying to keep that other shoulder up and a pin. That's the second time Alex has been pinned. Frustrated, but a gamer for sure. Yeah.
here's Avery for Frontier coming up to wrestle.
Avery Tuttle.
He tried to get a snap down, but didn't quite work.
Looks like he's grabbing the back of Avery's headgear. Can you do that? Can the headgear come into play?
Yeah, he's trying to get a collar tie-in right there. Right here, he got it. It's just it's more of a big man move usually, but...
Well, neither one of these guys are big, but I suppose whatever works.
Yeah, whatever works.
So Avery's neck is twisting pretty good there.
Oh, Avery looks like his headgear's in his eyes almost. That's a dangerous game when you're in a match. He goes for the shot. Right now, Pathfinder wrestler's trying to spin around for the two. Oh, so he's gonna get it.
Yep. Nice move. Still trying to push him over. Oh, he's got him.
There he is. Oh, he's got the leg too. That's dangerous.
Yep, that's a pin. Well played by the Pathfinder Pioneer. Yeah, Avery, that headgear didn't help him his cause at all in that match. Well played.
Looks like Andrew Wogan is getting ready for this next match. Yep. He's coming up to wrestle.
Here we go.
And what's different about exhibition matches is you can wrestle any weight class.
Oh, okay. So you can. So it doesn't have to be. You could have sort of anybody going against anybody, pretty much.
Yep. It's more for just to get experience. Yeah.
Oh, headgear gone.
Oh.
Heavy takedown. Oh, and the Pathfinder player looks like Pathfinder wrestler looks like he's slow to get up.
It looks like that might be an illegal return to the mat, potentially dangerous for Frontier.
Ooh.
It looks like he's gonna get some points for that. If you pick someone up off the mat, it's your responsibility to return them safely and allow them the chance to catch themselves.
I see. So the body slam that occurred will cost him points?
It may. To me, it looked like it was a relatively safe return, but due to the noise and the reaction of him on the ground, it looked like it hurt.
They're going to start from neutral.
And the Pathfinder wrestler looks like he does have a point on the board.
All right.
So that could be what that was from.
A lot of hand checking going on here. Minute to go. In the first period.
Oh, snap down. Logan grabbed the leg. He's going to come out on top. He gets the takedown.
All he's got to do is pull him over. Ooh!
He goes for the cross wrist ride.
Twenty-eight seconds to go in the first period. He's trying to pull him over. Pathfinder wrestler trying to hang on. And that'll do it in the first period. The score 2-1 in favor of the Frontier Redhawks.
Pathfinder's going to win the toss. He chooses top. So Logan will be trying to get the escape on this next.
He'll sit out.
Sits through. Oh! He's in a cradle. Oh, he's going to try to reverse it. Oh, there he goes. Yeah, come out. Coming on top. Yeah, crank over a cement job. He's on his back.
Nice bit of movement there. The Pathfinder wrestler's in trouble.
Andrew Logan is a first-year freshman. He's a first-year wrestler. He's a freshman. Big things are coming for this wrestler.
And a winner by pinfall. Nicely done. Great exchange there. And he wins the match by pin. Yeah, you're going to see a lot of him in the next few years.
He's also a football player.
Who do we have next?
Looks like Victor McNutt is getting ready to wrestle for Frontier.
Victor McNutt.
He runs track also. Two sports complement each other based off strength and speed.
Let's see what Victor can do here. This is a relatively feisty grappler he's up against. Victor's sporting quite the tan for the middle of winter.
Looks like the Pathfinder wrestler goes for a half Nelson, but Victor squirms out.
Victor looks like he's spent some time in the gym. Looks like he's in good shape.
And Victor gets the escape point.
Nice escape.
As we've seen from earlier, that escape point can win you the match.
Oh.
He's got the headlock.
He's trying to work him over. Oh. Got a bridge. Got him. Oh, good effort. With 1:04 to go in the first period, win by pinfall, is the Pathfinder Pioneer wrestler. Who's next?
Jackie Fong's making his way to the center of the mat for Frontier. And it looks like he's going to wrestle the Pathfinder 220.
Which would be Matt Monast, I think. Chris Fong lost in the heavyweight match to Zach Beeman. He's got a little bit more of a size advantage in this one, it looks like.
Jackie goes in for a shot, gets a leg. But Monast gets up. Some good solid defense there. Monast has got him in a front headlock position as Jackie works his way outside. They're going to start back in neutral position, it looks. Oh, no. Jackie's on the bottom. Oh, yeah. Back to neutral.
Yeah. I was going to say. Minute to go in the first period. No score yet.
Drag,
A lot of jockeying for position in this one. Sit. Oh, a takedown.
He gets his two. And it looks like he's going for a cross wrist ride, but Jackie's trying to muscle his way out of it. Monat's going to break him down. He's going to try to throw a half in the final seconds of the period.
16 to be exact. They're right close to the edge of the mat. Jackie wants a knock hit roll here. 5 seconds left. Oh, he's close. And saved by the bell in some ways. 2-0. Pathfinder with the lead going into period two.
And he gets the 3 back points for the near fall.
Yep, so it's 5-0 actually. Jackie will start from the down position. He's trying to move him. It's a big kid trying to flip over.
Oh,
but he got him. Jackie fighting. Nope, it's pinned. Well done by
some sportsmanship there.
Matt Monast, and he wins in that exhibition about 17 seconds into the second period. It's like another cruiserweight match coming up here.
It looks like Bailey's going to be out for another match. Bailey Murray from Frontier.
Yeah. Oh, can you use that with your hand like that and smack the guy in the head like that?
Yeah, make him blink before you take a shot.
Oh, Bailey's bridge. Got a bridge. Oof.
And he bellies out for the pin, but not before some back points to be awarded. And he throws a half and cranks him over.
Ooh.
Bailey bridges that again.
Nice. Just trying to grab that arm to flip him. Situation like this, you don't want to necessarily be on your belly, but it's better than being on your back, I suppose.
Yeah, sure is.
He's done a good job at spinning back out of that now.
Bailey is a strong wrestler. I've seen him bridge out of some pretty sticky situations.
Oh, look at this!
Season. I was going for the reversal.
This is a pretty sticky situation right now. 36 seconds left in period one. Bailey, again, is able to spin back to his stomach. This guy's got to be thinking, what am I going to do to get this guy turned over?
He's got that cross wrist ride.
10 seconds. He's driving Bailey's head into the mat. I can't feel too good. He's racking up the points, too, as the Pathfinder wrestler. 11-0 right now. That's going to do it in period one. So we'll start the second period.
Frontier wins the toss. Picks neutral.
So I got to go neutral. So you can pick neutral if you win the toss too?
Yep.
Yeah.
You pick top, bottom, neutral, or selective start.
Still riding him. Oh. So it's now 13-0. So this is they're racking the points up with 1:24 to go in the second. And again, Bailey trying to bridge back out.
And he flips him.
Whoa!
With the reversal.
And a near fall. So that should be what happened there. Oh, I guess he did he pin him? I'm not sure what happened, but it's 16-0, and that's how the match is going to end. And that is how our coverage in Meat's going to end. We're going to wrap it up in a moment as Frontier beats Pathfinder in their final home meet of the season. We're back to give you the wrap-up.